Hi everybody, welcome to this workshop of Python in Petroleum Industry. I am Rigoberto, and I'm gonna show you some useful function and function in Python that you can apply in some of areas in petroleum industry, like reservoir engineering. So before get started, I guess that all of you have a Python and Jupyter Notebook installed in your computers. We're going to use a Jupyter Notebook because it's a very easy way to code in Python and save or work, because you can add text and equations, so you can document your code. So I think we can start this workshop. So the first step here is to create a new Jupyter notebook. I am in a in my Jupyter directory. So in this case, I create a new notebook here, a notebook with Python. This is a Python notebook, Jupyter notebook. In here, we can rename the file. So, before to start with Python code, I want to show you some function of a notebook. In this case, we have a cell of code type. In this, we can write code. In this case, like as addition, with the shortcut control enter, we execute this line of code to add a new cell. We can use this button, insert new cell below, or we can use the shortcut alt enter, and we get a new cell. With the function print, we can print in the screen in the for example, a text. With control enter, you can see the difference between just execute and use print function. In this case, we get a text. Yeah, and in this case, we get an output in the code. Yes. So, with Alt Control, insert new cell. In this menu cell, we can change the cell type. The another cell type is the markdown. A markdown is a specific type of cell and syntax that you can insert text. You can insert text, image, equations. It's a specific syntax to generate reports. So you can see in this case, you can add a title, a main title with the hashtag sign. So, for example, workshop. We execute or execute this cell with control enter, we get a text, a square with the content with the text with a specific format. You can add text here, simple like that this example, and you can add a subsection title, for example, decline curve analysis. Hi again. Sorry, I had a technical problem with my internet. So you can add an equation using the LaTeX syntax. For this, use the dollar sign. And you can add the equation with subindex, use the down line. For super index, you use design, and with square brackets, you can define the equation here, and we can, and then we have an equation format. So it will be useful when you want to document your code, and you can actually add the equation in the line, in the same line of text, For example, here. Now I'm going to start with the first topic that is data structures. To declare a variable or define a variable, simply use the equal sign. For example, x equal 10. In this case, if you execute, you don't see the result. For see the value of a variable, you can simply write the variable here and the notebook show you the value of the variable. So in Python you have five main types of data. You have integers, you have float by data, that is data with decimal values. You have complex values. With complex you define with this letter. You have strings. Okay, with add a comment, you use the hashtag sign in the code cell type. With this, you get a comment, just a text that you can use to document your code. The last type of data is the Boolean. With print, we print, and with this, you have all the types of data: integer, float, complex, and strings, Boolean. So you can check the type of data, the data type of a variable with the type function. For example, type x, and you get the type of that of the type data of the x variable. Float. String. And the last one. Boolean. So this type of data, we can use different types of data in a collection variable. That is a collection variable. This is a simple variable. It's just a value for variable. But in Python we have collection of variables that in this type of variables we have in this case we have four main collection of variables. We have list, tuple, tuple. Tuple, sets, and dictionaries. So to generate a list in Markdown, if you can use just the number, just numeric, the list, and you can generate a list like this. So this is the four main types of collection variables. So we are going to start with the list. The list is defined using, for example, this, using the square brackets, just separate the values with commas. Yes. We can mix data types in a list. For example, this. You can add an integer and a string. For example, pressure. You can add a float. Yes. We have a string, integer, and float in the same list. You can access to the list element just with the using the square brackets. In Python, we start the lists and the others collection variables, the index of the element with zero is a zero indexing language. So if we know the first element in the list, we use zero. Sorry, we don't define list, just it's list one. And we get the first value. So we can, example, print. We can use print to show several values. The second value, you can use the negative values in the index. For example, minus one. The minus one show you the last element. If, for example, minus two, show you the element before the last. Sorry, is this one. Okay. Yes. The second one, the last one, and the before last one. So this is a way to access to this element. You can use some function with the list. For example, use the length function or the link function to know the length of the list. See, four elements in the list one. For example, three elements in the list mix. So you can generate a list with the, for example, with a specific step using the range function. The range function generate a range of value with a start element and the finish element with a specific step. For example, this. In this case, show you just the range function, but you can convert this in a list. And you can define a variable, for example, pressure, with this, and we have a list of pressure values. You can define a list of lists. You just define in the elements, for example, this. This is a list. The second element of the main list can be a integer link, a string list. Yes, and to access the element of the list, you need to use two of the square brackets. For example, this is the first element in the main list, and the last element in this list, we use this. Yes, we have three, this element. The first element and the last element inside the list. The next type of collection variables is tuple. Tuple is a variable, is like a list, but the elements are unchangeable. So in this case, you define a tuple with parentheses. Sorry, with these parentheses. Yes. If you apply the type, use tuple. In this case, in the case of a list, sorry, in this case, for example, I want to add some cells here. You can redefine the value of a list, the element, for example, the first element. Now I want to this element will be 5, and you redefine this value, the first element. But in the case of tuple, you can use this mode because this value are unchangeable. So in this case, you can use a quickly dummy variable. For example, you can convert this tuple in a list using list function. Since once the tuple is a list, you access to the first element and change the value, because this now is a list. Then ready in tuple, you can redefine all the variables. If you redefine all the variables, you can set this new list as the value of variable. And now you have the same tuple variable with the change element. The first element changed. You can see 1, 2, 3, in this case, 5, 2, 3. But when you use a tuple, because you don't want to change the value. So this is just a quickly way to change. The next type of collection is sets. Set is like a set, is math. They are just value in a set of value. With the final set, use the curly brackets. Sets have a singular ways to manage the data, because you can see they don't have a specific order, they just a set of values. So you can't use the index way to access for the value, because this object is not subscriptable. You can use this index way to access. You just or you can use you can use the in function. The in function is to know if a specific value is in the set. For example, pressure in set. Set one. Just with this, we get a boolean value and true value. That with this we know that pressure is in the set. Yes. And the last one, collection variables, is a dictionary. Dictionary consists of a collection of key value pairs to define for example, I want to generate a core simple dictionary. Use the curly brackets, but in this case you have to define the key that is it can be a string variable, a string or a numeric value. In this case, well, you use the 2 points sign and define the value of this key. In this case, for example, well, one. The next key, you can add more than one key in a, for example, in this case, we have a relative permeability test. And the deep of this core sample. Oops. Example numeric value here. Now you have a dictionary key. Just in this case, you can access with an element with the key. For example, I want to know the well is well one, or you can access with the index. You can use the index here. If you use some function with this, with, for example, the keys, and we get the keys of the dictionary, well, type, deep. And another way to work with dictionaries to create a list of a list of dictionary. First, we create an empty list. We can get this and create a dictionary here. And with the append function, you can add elements in the list. In this case, for example, the P element dictionary. And this way, we get the first element is a dictionary inside the list. So we can generate another element, for example, well two. This is a mercury injection pressure capillary pressure experiment. We append or add this element inside the list at the end of this list with the function append. And now we get more and more list, more and more dictionary inside the list. It's just a way to work with this, with list and dictionary. So with this, we finish the data types or data structures in Python. There are complex data structures, data frames, but in this case, I'm gonna show you just this. Now, we're going to talk about control flow, like loops and conditions. In this case, we get started with the for loop. That is useful when we know the how many times the code needs to be repeated. For example, I wanna generate a pressure list. And I want to print every element of this list. The basic syntax of a for loop is the for instruction. A counter or the is an element that will get the value of the list that use as a to get the control, in this case pressure. So in this case, for loop will be a get element by element of this list. So in this case we have six elements. So the for loop will be repeated six times. Yes, next is the code inside the for loop. In this case, we need to add a tab space, and all in this line of the code will be part of the for loop. In this case, just print I. So we can execute this. Okay. At the end of the for loop line, you have to add a double point, and we get the value, the print pressure value of every element. Yes. Another way is to use the range function. For example, range. If you define range with 6 elements, we can use the pressure list here. With this, E get the value of range for 0 to 5, that is 6 elements, and this element, this I element, use to access in the pressure list, so we get the same results here. This is the simplest way to use for loop. The other loop is the while loop. The while loop is used when you want to repeat the process until a condition is true. In this case, we need to specify it's very well the condition, because if you don't define the condition well, you will get a infinity loop. Just with while is the same. We use the while function. In this case, we use the a count variable, for example, I. E until I will is smaller than 10, the process is repeated. In this case, we define first an initial value of I, in this case 0. We can print I value here just to see how works the function. And in this case, we need to redefine in every steps of the loop and add a value of the I variable, in this case 1, to increase this value and the loop finish in some moment. So okay, is 2 point. Yes. In this case, print the tens until the I is smaller than 10. 1, 2, 3. Example, if you have a pressure list or array list, From 100 to 2600 with a step of 100, and you want to use just the pressure value smaller than the bullet point pressure. In this case, it's here. You have a list with some values, and you print just the values that are less than bullet point pressure. In this case, this. So this is a way to use the this is very useful, the while loop, when you do iterative process like a Newton-Raphson, some compressibility factor correlation use Newton-Raphson, so this is they are iterative process, so you can stop the loop when the error in the process is less than a specific value. So it's a way to use the while loop. Now I'm going to show you the conditions statements. The condition statement that the if function. Here I want to add, you can add an image in Markdown, for example, comparison operators. If the file, if the image file is in the same directory of the notebook, just add the name of the file and the format. We have some operators within the condition statements. We have the equal, different than, the greater than, less than, greater or equal to, less or equal to. This is a function is to identify the or to know the type of data types of a variables. For example, when you in the bullet point pressure correlation of baskets and bags, you have to know if the oil KPI gravity is less or greater than 30, Because depending of the of this value, you have to use different coefficients in the correlation. In this case, A, B, and C coefficient depend of the value of API oil gravity. So this is example to use the condition. For example, if we know if we have a 25 API oil, API, this is a syntax of a of condition if, just use the if function. Sorry again. I guess you well. In this case, we define the A, B, and C coefficient according to the API value. So we can code below the if statement. Just remember to write the code in the line of the if, o sea, in at the left, because all in this line and the in the tab are inside the if statement. Okay, we can do this. Yes, if we change this value greater than 30, well, in this case we they change the value are defined, so but you define it before. The value don't change of the initial value of zero. So you can use this statement with the else. There is a second way to in the condition. The L is when the this condition is false. You do the code will do this. So in this case, if the value is not is greater than 30, just we define the coefficient in this way with another values. For example, here. In this case, the value of the coefficient is are this. So in this case, we have the if statement and the else statement. The last one is the elif statement. Elif, in this case, we can use this. And for example, we can add here the AND operator to add a new condition. And in this case, uh, In this case, the two conditions must to be true to enter here. And in this case, if we can use the elif, if we use the elif, we can define a new condition here. No, sorry. This here and this zero, and else, for example, this. In this case, we have two conditions: API smaller or equal to 30, and greater to zero. In this case, we define this value of the coefficient. In the case of the API greater than 30, we use this value. In the case this condition is false and this condition is false, we have the else statements. And in this case, we just define the coefficient as zero. So this case is greater than 30. Yes, and is zero, we get zeros. Just is a way to use if statement with a property correlation. Just with this, we finish the condition statements, and we can pass to the Python libraries. The libraries are a set of code packages packaged in the in a specific with a specific name that you can use, and is a set of function that you can use in your code. The first library that I want to show you is the NumPy. NumPy is very useful because NumPy extends the Python, the data types in Python. And with these new data types, including the arrays, you can vectorize your operation, because it's very useful because you can use an array, a vector, as a variable to multiply this every element in this array multiply with a scale. So it's very useful. First, if you don't have the NumPy installed, you can install NumPy as a library with the py command. Just a moment, please. Well, if you don't, have the NumPy library installed, you can use this command pip install NumPy. Pip is a library that is in Python. Actually, when you install Python, you install pip. So with this command pip install NumPy, you install the NumPy library. In this case, I have already installed the NumPy library, so I get this message. So before use NumPy, you need to install it. When you already install NumPy, after install NumPy, you have to import the NumPy libraries into the workspace. So for this, you use the import function, and a common way to import a library is to define this library with a short name, in this case np, and with np you can access with the function and methods and classes inside the NumPy library. So in this case, with this we can use the np. You call a function with the np with the NumPy library, in this case array, and you define an array. You can define another array. And you can sum these two arrays. Sorry. Yes. You can see in this case this addition is element by element. If you try to do this with a simple list, in this case, a simple list that we see before, you get a different result. In this case, the list B add in the list A at the end as a new element. So this is very useful. You work to the right when you need to do operation with several elements, and with this you are about to use a loop for this simple operation. So in this case, I want to show you how to use these methods or these functions of write to generate a solution gas ratio values with the standing correlation. So in this here, we have the standing correlation in LaTeX syntax to see the equation. We can see that we have four variables or input data variables. We need the gas gravity, a pressure values, the oil API gravity, and a temperature value or temperature reservoir. So we can start to generate to create the a pressure list or a pressure array. Actually, you can use the, for example, range function here to generate a specific list with an element separated with a specific step. We can define the input data, the gas gravity, the oil API gravity, and the reservoir temperature in Fahrenheit degrees. Yes. With this, we can define the RS values using the correlation above. So the first step is multiply, divide the pressure values by this value. Then multiply with 10 power with this value with the multiply with the API. All of this, let me show you the parentheses. I think this is, we don't need this. In this case, sorry, is for a potential or a power definition with a base and exponent. You need to use a double multiply sign. So in this case, we execute this code. One way that is fine. Oops, we have an error here. Okay. Now we get the solution gas ratio and array of solution of ratio. You can see with just to multiply this array variable here, you get a element by element operation. So it's very useful to work with array, with NumPAR array. So to visualize all results, we need to plot this value pressure versus solution gas ratio. the more often way to plot in Python is using the another library, the matplotlib library. Again, if you don't install, if you haven't installed the library in your Python environment, you can use this comma. This is the name of the library. In this case, I already installed the library, so we get this message. I get this message. So again, before to plot any data, you need to import the matplotlib library. In this case, we just import the pyplot function, that is the main function to plot in Python with this library. And all of these will be defined as plt. We add this command to plot in the main line of the code is created. So we execute this. And the simplest ways to plot is use the plot function. In this case, pressure with RS. And we created a simple plot. If you want to see this, use the plt, the show function, to show just the plot. You can change the color of the line. This is in the default option, blue and solid line. You can change this a red color, the width of the line, and the style of the line. In this case, dash it. And see the options is applied. You can add X labels, in this case pressure, with PSI units, and the Y label is solution or glass ratio with standard Q feed. And Stockton values. Well, all of these have to use a string value with the, and you have a plot. It's a basic plot with it's a very pretty plot. So in this case, we already see two libraries, the NumPy libraries and the matplotlib libraries. I'm gonna show you another two libraries. In this case, is the pandas library. Pandas is useful to work with a specific type of data called data frames. Data frames is useful to generate, to when you work with several variables and observation. In this case, I'm gonna use this library to import a file. Just to import a file into your notebook. First, we import the pandas library as PD. We can use PD read CSV file. In this case, the file is this. This is a file of gas rates, well gas rates. Okay, CSV. The file have two columns, the days, or the production days, and the rate, gas rates. You can see in this case, you can check the type of data of this with the type function. And this is a pandas data frame, okay? And you can see that Jupyter generated a pretty well table. With this table or data frame, we get the, we create two variables, the date variable that is the with this command nilog, you can access to the data frame. In this case, we get the values of the all rows. With this command, you access to all rows of the first column. Yes, that is the days column. And we can say, we can use the same command to use to access to the second column. Remember that Python is a zero index language. So the first is zero. In this case, the second is one. So with this, we get this value as a simple values. You can see the type of value of this, just to see what type of value you have. It's a number array, yes? So, now with Matplotlib, you can generate a scatter plot. In this case, we can use the scatter function. And we have the production, the gas production well, the gas production of the well. We can use here, copy this here, change this days. And change this right. Just QG. Well, I want to show you how you can use non-linear regression or linear regression. In this case, it's a non-linear regression because you don't have a linear behavior. But with the SciPy library, you can use the curve fit function to optimize an equation. and get the values that fit the your observed data. So this is another libraries, SciPy. You can install this library with the same command. Install SciPy. So you import this is another way to import a specific function. In this case, from this library, we import this function, just core fit function. So we execute here. I want to write the equation that we're going to use is the general hyperbolic equation. In this case, we are going to use the curve fit function to get the value of initial rate, declination, initial declination, declination, and declination exponent of the ARPS equation to fit all this production data. So, first, we need to define a function, a Python function. To define a function in Python, you use the def function. Let's see. In this case, hyperbolic. This function need for input data, the times, the initial rate, the declination and the initial declination. This function return the value of rate and a specific time. So we need to write this equation as a mathematical expression here. In this case, initial rate and all of these we're not. Yes, you can see the equation is here. So when you use this function and you pass the specific time, initial rate, declination exponent, and initial declination, you get for the function return a rate and these specific times. So this function is used to this function will be used with the curve fit function. Oh my God, we have okay, let me respond your question before to continue. In this case, okay, why is not using impression number 205? In Python, we have a issue that the right value, where is? Okay, here, you can see here, in Python, in this case, this value is exclusive, So the code just get from this, and the value before this is like if you try to access, for example, in this list, and you can access to several elements, but if you try to access from first to the 30 to the third element, you can think that you can use this, but in this case you just get two values because this value is exclusive. Python take the value before that, before this. You need to use the value, the next value, in this case 3, to get the first 3 elements. So this element 3, in this case is this, is exclusive. Just take this. This is the answer of this. Well, the advantage of Python is that you have is in first is open source, and you have a lot of libraries that you complement your code, and you have a lot of function right with others. So as you can see, you can use NumPy to vectorize operation. You can use matplotlib to plot. You have some function to fit curve. You can generate web page. We have some libraries to read web log files, the last files. Many companies use this. Many companies, like I don't know, or softwares, commercial softwares like TechLog or Pipesync or RMS of geomodeling have an API in Python, and an API is you can access with the data in this project or in this different commercial software with Python, so you can generate your own script and improve the you can use your own script in these software. You can maybe improve some task or add some equation that the software don't have. So it's a very big Python, but you need to focus maybe for example, in this case is petroleum industry. So the most use is NumPy, is some libraries that you can make operation, you plot, you read a specific file, because it's very big Python that you can maybe lose in the way. So, but it's very useful Python. Okay, actually, it's one. Talk about TechLog. Well, now I wanna show you. We are working with library that you can use in TechLog, I guess. Okay. Well, in Petrel directory is not a API. I know a plugin for a company called Seagull. They have a plugin that connect Petrel with Python. So, but it's an external plugin. So in Petrel is not directly the way to work with API with Python. The question is with the LaTeX syntax. You start with this sign, the money sign. LaTeX has a specific syntax to define subindex and superindex with this sign to define fraction. You have to search a little in Google with LaTeX syntax or LaTeX in example, LaTeX like this. Yes, LaTeX. Because it's very wide the syntax in LaTeX, so I suggest you to share to look for some example in Google with LaTeX syntax. Okay, let me unmute.
Hello, sir. Good
Hi.
Oh, Mr. Member for the presentation. It's wonderful. Are you hearing me?
Yes. Sorry, can you repeat? I can understand with my internet.
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay, sorry. Yeah, sorry. Presentation, appreciate it. It's wonderful.
Sorry, can you write in the chat because my internet is very bad, so
Oh, yeah, sorry.
I can
Okay, let me
hear
write.
you.
Okay, I want to ask. Okay. Okay, I want to ask that, like, how can we launch the application on our system?
Can you repeat, please?
I said, how can we launch the Jupyter software on our system? Like, how can we open the application on our laptop?
Sorry, I can't understand your question.
I said, like, how can we open, like, install or open the application on our system, like the Jupyter installation? How can we install it on our system, on our laptop?
Okay.
So that's my question.
How to install a Jupyter in your system? Okay. Jupyter, let me show you how to install.
Okay, thank you very much. Let me see.
Well, you can use the same command, pip install Jupyter lab. With this command, you install Jupyter in your machine. To start Jupyter notebook, you in this case in the in this in the Windows command, you execute this command, Jupyter notebook, and you press enter. With this, Jupyter open in your web browser. In this case, is Chrome, and you can the first yeah, Jupyter show you is the first main directory user, and in this way you can create folder to create your Jupyters. So with this, open the Jupyter main page. It's not required to install Jupyter, but it's a way to work with Python in a maybe to start work and learn Python. You can use another KDE or environments, development environments like Eclipse or like I don't remember another. For example, PyCharm or Visual Studio Code, they are IDs to Python code, exactly. Anaconda, Spider, PyCharm. I'm gonna send all the data and the notebook to ScholarGate, so don't worry for that. Yes, I am from Mexico. So continue with the example of CoreFit. With this function, CoreFit needs three basic input data, a function that the function that will be fit the data, in this case days, the x data and the y data, in this case the rate. So with this, we can execute this code. Okay, with 2 points here, and we can print the results. In this case, CoreFit, with CoreFit, we get two main results: the value of this fit data or coefficient of the equation. In this case, this is the initial rate, the exponential decline, and decline initial decline. This is the best value to feed the data, and in this case we have a interval of confidence with the feed, but in this case we just use this that are the best feed coefficient. We have to get the fit values. We can use the the value of the value and use the hyperbolic function that we defined before. We use the days in the time, in the t values, the time values. In this case, this is a list, so we can get with the index, the first value is the initial rate, the second value is the exponential, and the last value is the initial decline. And now I'm gonna show you how to plot this, the feed and the data, the feed data and the original data. Yes, and I'm gonna show you the result of this. It's the same with it's the same in this case. We define a specific function, but you can define another function here, a line, simple function. This is the original data. We are the feed data now. In this case is this. I'm gonna use a new cell for this. Okay, white label. And you can see the original data and the feed points using the hyperbolic equation of the decline curve analysis. You can use another equation here, maybe. Maybe for unconventional resolver, like I don't remember the names, but another equation here to optimize and to feed the data. Increase the size of your plot with this code, with this line. Okay, the file, the CSV file is called here, read CSV function of the pandas library. We read this data variable is a pandas data frame. And with this data frame, we take just the values. Well, in this case, we have just two columns. Well, this is all I want to show you in this workshop. I hope all of these will be useful for you. If you have another uh, we can start with doubts, questions. Well, con a double quotes when in my keyword, I use alt number 2, but this is a Latin American keyword. I can see you, I can see you how to create faster, but in Jupyter, when you create something, like a double keyword, Jupyter or another ID, write the others and close the parentheses or the double quotes. Well, the protein functions. The basic is just to use the plot function. If you use just the plot function with this, you get a basic line plot. Yes? So to add, you can later add more values, that color, but the simplest way is plot. With plot, you create a line plot. To create a scatter plot, you can use the scatter function. Define the x and y values, and then you can add another. Another option like labels, ticks, a title, another way, scales. Neural networks is easy using the library. Let me the scikit-learn library. With scikit-learn, you can define this library have a lot of function with machine learning algorithms, like neural networks. A face environment simulator, not yet. I already checked some algorithms, but I work a basic code. So let me unmute.
Hello, everyone. Hello, Rigoberto. Can I ask a question? It's more easier to ask like this than writing a lot of questions and boring you. Thanks for the great training. It was very great session, useful. Thank you. My question is, I'm a starter in Python, and that's why I learned a lot of things in this training today. And I'm a geologist, oil and gas geologist. And you showed mainly plotting all these hyperbolic exponential curves here, which is good. But for example, I'm using Petrel, TechLog, Spotfire, all others different softwares, right? So, and most of those softwares softwares doing most of the job for us. How can I use Petrel in my, you know, to make my works easy? Like as I say, as I asked, relating Python to Petrel or Tclog or other softwares. Thank you.
Okay. Well, Sorry with my connection. In the case of Petrel, I remember a month ago I had a problem with logs. I export a log last file with RMS. It's a Yomori software with of Rockstar of Emerson. I export the last file and I try to import in Petrel and I have problems. So I use a Python library called Lazio. In Lazio, you can read last file. Then in this case, I read the last file with Lazio and then export the last file with Lazio. And then I import the last in Petrel. And in this case, I resolve the problem with Python. In the case of, I can tell you a specific way to use Python in your in some task, but you can use Python before to analyze your data or to categorize your data before work with another software. Yes. Thank you. Lazio is in this. Yes, Lazio is in the PyP project. So you can use Lazio. It is Lazio and another, this Whaley. Whaley is another library to manage well data. Whaley. We can use Whaley too. Actually, Whaley use Lazio to read last file. But with Whaley, you can plot logs in an easy way. Is for Geoscience, for Cargill Geoscience is a company that use Python and create some libraries. So I hope that you see in this workshop, it will be useful for all of you. Thank you for assist in this workshop.